Hello everyone, welcome back to the final game of Let's Celebrate Mega Man's 25th Anniversary! I'm Ultima Mantoid. In the year 20XX AD, the first annual robot tournament was held. Looks like we got a samurai, a native, a centaur, a plant, with 8 of the world's most powerful robots, but some wind guy, a knight, a snowman, something else. Mr. X, the sponsor of the tournament, took control of the robots and began to take over the world. Mr. X, why?
It's time to tell you the truth. I've been manipulating that fool Dr. Wily from the beginning. But now I no longer need Dr. Wily's help. Come and face my power, Mega Man.
We'll stop you. Follow me, Rush. And thus, the story of Mega Man 6, the final NES game of the series and the final Let's Celebrate 25th Anniversary game for Mega Man. I'll let you all listen to the intro, and there's actually an in-game demo, and I'll let it play through too, so you all can kind of see. I don't think anybody else has ever shown it off. Probably not. Wow, it fires awful strange. He's just like, it's like jump and shoot man here. Oh wait, no, that nickname is specifically reserved for Mega Man Crossover, because it's literally just Jump and Shoot Man. And that was a terrible player. That person needs to not play Mega Man, because he's terrible. So, we'll begin. We get 8 themed robot masters that represent various portions of the world in this game. We have the Native American Tomahawk Man, I believe it's the Greek Centaur Man, I think he's from Greece, the Medieval Knight Man, the Japanese Samurai Yamato Man. I wish I could remember where Plant Man was from. But yeah, he's special. The Canadian Blizzard Man. The Chinese Wind Man. I think he's either Chinese or Holland. I don't remember. I'll have to look. And the Arabian Flame Man. So, we're going to start with... Let's see, who should we start with? Actually, you know what? We're going to start with Flame Man. Yeah, we'll start with Flame Man so I can show off some things. And look, a completely new, like, intro. Like, you get to see boss stats and everything. That's one reason that this is one, I think, one of the best in the franchise. Now, the gimmick for this level is there's oil everywhere. And we can't... See that cracked block? Those will come in handy later. See how we have normal, which is NOR, and just the Mega Buster? Yeah, we don't start with any rush coil or anything in this game. But we do get the charge shot, so... Now I'm going to show you what happens when these things attack. Well, that. It becomes an instant death trap. Those are how spikes are made in this level. Honestly, I don't know if, I don't know if there are spikes in this level. Otherwise, I don't believe there are. Now, this right here, the only way you can handle these guys is literally with a fully charged shot. Because if you just fire regular at them, that's all you get. So, charge at Buster and fire. I thought it was a neat mechanic, but if you knock them into the oil, they inflate into like a life raft, and depending on what direction you face when you jump and land on them, will depend on, you know, what direction you go. And it has to be a fully charged shot, too. And this right here is why you want these guys. They're pretty useful, huh? We'll just jump over you instead. Wow, that was a good shot on my part. By the way, I still have the rum from last night, so shot count has been reset to 0 because I could not physically carry on after Mega Man V. Mega Man 5 for Game Boy. Let's put it this way. As soon as I finished the video, my bed became the pillow. Not the bed was, you know, I didn't actually get into bed. I laid in my chair. Well, that answered that question. If you're in it when it goes off, I don't think it's instant death. And yes, those guys can set fire to the oil as well. Which I... This game is so racially stereotypical that it's hilarious. Because no other Mega Man game dares this stuff. I mean, you have an Arabian-themed robot master who is in an oil field, and he wears a turban. You can't tell me that's not, like, racially inconsiderate. And the game doesn't give any fucks at all. Well, I can't say it's inconsiderate, because it's stereotypical, not inconsiderate. Flame Man's a really interesting boss as far as fighting him. He's got a shield mechanic. And that's one of the reasons he's interesting. You've got to know how to dodge that, and it's not easy to dodge. You can jump into the air when he, That's what makes him tough. I did press the jump button. What the fuck? Well, maybe I can do it now that I have more HP. Let's get the, rum back out. I put it in a bag to keep it safe. One of those nice plastic, like, Walmart bags. Actually, I think that one's from Walgreens. Alright. First shot. Let's hope this isn't indeed any indication of the rest of the game. I'm hoping I did not make a mistake in picking Flame Man first. Okay, that one was a bit rough going down. Shit, I meant to charge. Oh well. Unloading on him as early as you can and as quick as you can is a very big key to actually beating him. And he always seems to know... Oh, that's right! They changed that stupid mechanic in this game. See? He has a bit of a shield mechanic. He can... There is a freaking delay between the end of a slide and jumping. And you also lose your charge shot whenever... Okay, what in the hell is going on with my controls? But he's dead. Thank God. I thought I'd bit off more I could chew starting with him. Something's really weird with my, controller. I don't get it. Unless the game is like this and I just don't remember. But you actually get, like in Mega Man 5 for the Game Boy, you actually get a quick demonstration of what the weapon does. That's the Fire Blast. Or Flame Blast, rather. And, of course, as you all know, fire melts snow. Or just heat in general, because snow's not very, you know, very strong. But we get Blizzard Man, the Master of Snow. He's Canadian, eh? You have a ski-based robot. Master. Oh, look! Ice mechanics! How I did not miss you! Now, the cool thing with the flame blast is this right here. That's why it's kind of neat. But on a plus note, I'm totally gonna die here. Yep. I knew I shouldn't have done that. What was I thinking? That's already shot two, and I'm on the second stage. Damn. That means I gotta be careful. Forgot this game's a bit dangerous at times. So, what I was going to talk about in this video is the future of Mega Man and what I believe Capcom needs to do in order to save the franchise in the long term and to keep its fans returning. I totally thought I was gonna die there. We have timer bombs, as they become useful later on in the series as well. Let me make sure my jumping is working here. Okay, everything seems to be working. And I'm gonna check it on a slide here in a moment. See that cracked ice block up there? Nothing we can do about it yet. Yeah, we can't, we can't do, like, a short... Yeah, we can't do a slide into a jump in this game, so... However, we do want that, so I will go ahead and fire blast through here. Flame blast, excuse me. Because apparently I keep calling everything fire in this game. We get the shield attackers. They return in this game, too. There's so many stereotypes in this game, and I'm not talking, like, bows. You know. Or not bows. Bows does, I'm not talking, like, Kenwood or Pioneer, either. Mini-bosses become more prevalent in this game as well. One thing I do like is when you fire the Mega Buster here, it actually stays in a straight line from where you fire it. Including all of the ones that the Sniper Joes get from their little thing. So yeah, this one has probably the clumsiest controls of the original series. If only because you can't slide and then jump. On top of that, when you get hit, the Buster loses its charge. They went with the traditional explosion for when enemies die instead of doing something new. But... Blizzard Man's weakness is the Flame Blast, so we'll go ahead and get that out. And I, like I said, I wanted to talk about the future of Mega Man, where I think it needs to go from here. Capcom has a big opportunity here to make it up to the fans with this year. Everyone already is thinking it. If they really want to make a big blowout for Mega Man this year, they know what they need to do. They need to finish Mega Man Legends 3. The game might as well have been 90% done. And then they canceled it. So if they really, truly want to make Mega Man fans come back to Capcom, to come back to support in full Mega Man, they need to stop putting out stupid shit like Mega Man Crossover, which might as well be called Jump and Shoot Man. Because... it's auto-scroll to the right, you press a jump button and a fire button without any thought. It auto-walks to the right for you, which is pathetic. We'll go after Plan Man next.
The gayest robot master of them all, he's the flower fancier. My pickles.
Totally did not mean to sound like, what's his name from Metalocalypse? These grasshoppers are annoying because your regular Buster shots will go over them. As you progress through the levels, though, you will get rush adapters. There is no rush coil in this game. There is no rush jet in this game. You get Power Mega Man and Jet Mega Man. Now, Power Mega Man can blow up the blocks. And he has a very short-ranged attack. But... we can do that. And it decimates things. However, he loses his slide. Only 3 charge shots kill that thing. Whereas it takes, I think it's like 14 shots from the regular Buster, which means it would be like 6 shots from a charge Buster. I don't remember how many shots that thing takes. All I know is that if you do use it on a boss, it actually does more damage. I think it's like 6 points of damage. I don't remember. I may test this, though, against Plant Man, because he's a fairly easy boss. Now, we have a giant monkey guardian here. And he can die without having to shoot his fist. If you shoot his fist, it knocks him back, and it keeps him from encroaching on your territory. So. Anyway, the future of Mega Man. They need to release Legends 3. There is no ifs, ands, or buts. If they want to have the Mega Man fans come back and support the series and not say, we hate you, Capcom, because, you know, for the love of God. See? You shoot his fist, it knocks him back. Then they need to release Legends 3. There is no other way around it. And if Capcom somehow watches this video, you know what you need to do. There is no ifs, ands, or buts about it. Legends 3 needs to happen. You announced it, you canceled it, and the fans want it. It is 100,000 people backing it. And you're going to say that it wouldn't sell enough. If you put it on the DS, and you have 100,000 people wanting it, right? This is one of the reasons I hate this stage, by the way. It's a tough stage. Well, that was a convenient dodge. If you have, let's say you have 100,000 people. You offered Legends for $35 on the DS. Right? Now, let's think about that. Mathematics. Here. The slowdown really helped me there. I probably wouldn't have been able to snag past that without getting hit. Anyway, 100,000, that's $3.5 million at least that they'll make. And now if they offered it for more than that, like 40, you're still looking at a marginal profit, I'm sure, because it's a handheld game. Handheld games are cheaper to develop than, you know, these big console games, like, you know, and I'm gonna, and as much as I hate the series, it's a very good example. Call of Duty, you know, it has a huge production budget, I'm absolutely sure. And you can't tell me that that game doesn't sell, because it does. It really does, despite, you know, how much you or I may dislike the game, it sells. Therefore, they can afford to put the big budget into it. They don't have to worry about the budget costs. They know people will buy it. I'm sure they have some sort of limitation. You know, they can't be an extravagant, you know, we're going to drop 100 mil on the next Call of Duty game, you know? And the reason I use Call of Duty is, despite how much I dislike the game, it really is a good benchmark for the first-person shooter to compare and contrast with prices and costs and such. For whatever reason, the Native American Tomahawk Man doesn't like flowers. Tomahawk Man, Master of Tomahawk. How? Again, stereotypical. I'll look more into Plant Man later when I actually do the real LP of this game. This is not an LP. Neither was the last video. These are celebratory video postings. An LP will consist of multiple parts done by me with more detail towards the game instead of mindless rambling about, you know, just things that are on my mind that I wish to talk about. So, what else can they possibly do? I know, people have talked about, well, if you're going to do it, you need to put Mega Man X9 out. I don't like the idea of a Mega Man X9. The reason that I don't like a Mega Man X9, or at least don't like the idea of it, is because if you play the Zero series, you understand what happens, to a brief extent at least, between X8 and Zero-1. If they make an X9 and they want it to be chronological, for the most part, Zero will either A, not need to be playable in this game, or B, will need to... Wow, I already got the jet adapter too? Oh, I meant to show you. If you switch between jet and power, Rush just does that. And I'll show you from power to jet. Jet Mega Man! And then going from normal Mega Man to Jet Mega Man does the same thing. Pressing jump a second time gives you a small jet boost. It recharges its energy extremely quickly, so technically you have infinite, but not when you need infinite. Like, it does drain. So, and the mechanics behind this are actually pretty cool. If you are falling a long distance and you try to use it, then it, ironically enough, you will have a bit of a hang. Like, you're trying to actually correct the direction. I'll show you. Because right here it's safe. Okay, I have fallen a screen. See what I mean? It does start slowing you down, but it's not enough. If that makes any sense. I'm just going to skip this guy. Well, not before I take a hit or two. At least he doesn't do a massive amount of damage. What else can there be? Oh yeah, but it was, as I was saying though, about Mega Man X9, if they do that, Zero will either need to A, not be playable at all, or he will need to be in the prologue stage. The prologue stage needs to focus mainly on him and no one else, unless they somehow pull some story out of their ass from between what's already written in stone. We're gonna go to the north path, by the way. Up. This is a very tricky block to destroy, at least in my experience. You want to tiptoe to the very edge. See how short range it is? And then throw, and you get a cameo by Proto Man, who gives you the energy balancer, which was introduced in this game and not Mega Man 5 for the Game Boy. Keep that in mind. Now, we're going to go the bottom path. There's a trick to this game. Tomahawk, Yamato, Centaur, and Knight, they all have two boss rooms in their stages. The reason this is important is that one is a quote-unquote fake boss. It fights the exact same, there is no difference. The other one is the real boss, and the real boss will give you the beat parts in this game. See, the energy balancer, I don't have to switch over to the blizzard attack. See, I don't have to switch over to the blizzard attack. We'll go this way, and we will go encounter the real, the real Tomahawk Man. What else can they possibly do to please Mega Man fans? Maybe a new series that kind of ties them all together, or a new game that's not Mega Man crossover that perfectly displays, you know, 25 years of Mega Man, like they did with Sonic Generations. You know, they did 20 years of Sonic, and they brought old Sonic and new Sonic together in a game. They could always do something like that. Are you serious? Thought I had that, because I had the shield out, but I should have hit him with it, but I didn't. I'm not gonna like this. After fighting Buster only, he's actually one of the tougher bosses in this game. isn't saying much, because most of the bosses are piss easy in this game, sadly enough. Especially when they have their weaknesses used against them. You don't want to stay too far away from him, but you want to stay far enough away where he can't devastate you. Oh my god. You want to stay a good enough distance where he can't hit you with the feathers. I'm gonna down an energy tank just so I don't have to die again. And it uses even quicker jump mechanics in this game, so they change those too. If they do a 0-5, I'll be pissed off, because the way 0-4 ends, 0-5 can't happen. And I'm pretty sure most of the fans are smart enough to realize that that won't happen. So, oh, wait. I don't know why I hit continue. Tell you what I'll do. I will commit suicide, and I'm not going to drink for it because I goofed up and hit the wrong damn thing. For some reason, I was thinking continue was suddenly, all of a sudden, continue with the game, not continue with the same level. Duh. I'm already doing stupid shit, and I'm only on my third drink. And I'm not even feeling it yet. I don't remember who it was, but thank you for the nickname Drunkima Drunktoid. This doesn't happen very often, the whole drinking thing. And one of my managers at work that knows about me doing this celebration, he's like, these are the first signs of an alcoholic. You should just name all these videos the progression of an alcoholic. And I just kind of laughed. Alright, so we'll game over on purpose. And we'll stage select this time. Now, see how there's a B there? If you go to the fake one, then it doesn't show up. So we will now go to Yamato Man stage. Yamato Man, master of spear! Ha! He's probably a follower of the Code of Bushido, too. But that's one thing I do love about this game. The Robot Master diversity, it represents the world over. I mean, yeah, stereotypically, but it represents the world over so well. I mean, you've got the Japanese Honorable Bushido Samurai, which everybody knows Japan for one of three things. Their computer products, their samurai, and their rich, rich history, and their beautiful buildings. Or they're born. That's the three things Japan is known for. Okay, that was just cool. When I said the word Japan just now, a tiny little bubble popped out of my mouth. And it just kind of floated around in the air for a moment. Yeah, apparently my body is telling me that I'm drunk because it's giving me all the cartoon bubbles where it's like, did not know that. Apparently the bombs will block your shots. They give you plenty of energy tanks in this game, if I remember right. But yeah, the way Zero ends, there is absolutely no way that they can ever have a 0-5. And the way that I've heard ZX Advent ends, I don't think there can be a sequel to it too. However, on the contrary, guess what? ZX Advent ties into Legends like 80,000 years later, but still, it ties into Legends. Now, if you have the jet, you can be nosy and fly up this way. Which is the normal path, by the way, if you don't have the jet. Wow, that was by the skin of my teeth. That was literally by the skin of my teeth. Which, my teeth have no skin, so I suppose it was by nothing then. Oh, you clever fishy, you! Clever fishy. That means number 4, and I'm only halfway through the Robot Masters in this game. Fucking great! And the Wily stages are fucking tough in this game. Like, the bosses are all easy. But the stages, however, in this game, they actually did a pretty good job. All of the musical tracks in this game are phenomenal. The only problem is that if you really listen close enough, you'll hear a slight static tinge. Do you kind of hear it? It doesn't sound as clear as in the previous Mega Man installments. Now, the reason that the music sounds like it has a tiny bit of like a tinge to it, this game was rushed in development very badly. And I think had they taken the full amount of time to develop this game, it would have been right up there with Mega Man 2, at least in my opinion. Had they, you know, fine-honed the slide into a jump mechanics, I can't do it. I can't slide into a jump. That is one thing that bugs the piss out of me about this game. Well, hello there, lag. And I think this is the correct path. Oh, no, it isn't. I'll have to come back to this stage. This is what happens. You'll actually get to see it. I should have actually used the jet to go up there. That's not the normal path, I don't believe. Silver Tomahawk. What I love is he actually runs over to pick the spearhead up. Because he only has the one on his actual spear. Look, that's one thing I love to the detail of this game. He throws the spearhead off, it goes flying, hits the wall, and he actually runs over, picks it up, and puts it back on his weapon. You can't tell me that that's not kind of cool. Nice attention to detail there. I don't know why my throat's being a bitch. Fucking really? I need a paper towel, damn it. I picked my drink up from work, and I lift it up, I put the straw in my mouth, and it's fucking dripping down the top of the lid. Fucking really? I'll be sticky with tea and lemonade later. Gah. Oh well. See? There's no bee here, so I'm gonna go back and do his stage again. They even tell you what kind of battery they run off. See, he's solar-powered. So during nighttime, I guess he would have to run on all the solar energy he's collected. Which is kind of neat. They actually tell you what kind of fucking battery that they run on. I'm surprised that Plant Man isn't like flower power or something. He eats all of the plants forever. We'll go this other way then. Just because I can show it off. I do want to see if it works. Just hit me, I want to try it. Okay, it does work in this game. They have no invulnerability frames when they're hit, so you can fire as rapidly as you want. Just let him drop it down in the hole when you see him. But yeah, the Legend series, the X series, and the Classic series are about the only series that they can revisit, because literally the Zero series has an ending where there's no way they can continue it. I'm not spoiling anything. I will eventually do a Mega Man Zero playthrough. I have a bunch of Mega Man games before I can get to that, because if you remember, I said I would LP these games chronologically. Spoiler and hint. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Or at least as chronologically as I can. I'm gonna hit him with the Yamato Spear. Which, by the way, is a neat weapon. It's very straightforward, very fast, very accurate. But if you look, one goes down and the other goes up. Notice? They don't tell you that in school. They don't teach you these things. That spears can just go in a direction and then go another direction and they don't stop. I think the original series, when they finally end it, it's going to be... like, I don't think they'll ever end the original series. Everybody knows what happens, but I don't think they'll ever actually end it. Because at this point, I believe that the vanilla Mega Man series is just... it's so wildly popular when it comes out. I mean, when they actually release an old classic 8-bit Mega Man game that... develops the story, and if it hits you, the spear, let me interrupt myself here, the spear, if it hits you, it leaves it on the floor, which is kind of neat too. See? Bam! It's on the floor, not against a wall. Which you can use to your advantage to make him easier to hit. At least, you know, but if you're trading blows, then that's not a good thing, but if you've got the silver tomahawk, then yeah. But the original series, I don't really know if they'll ever end it. I mean, they very well could. I mean, we could... if you have ever beaten the game Mega Man and Bass... if you beat it with Bass, you'll actually see blueprints to Zero in the background. Spoiler, for those that have never played Mega Man but are interested in the story and have been using my videos to get into it. Wily built Zero. He's also solar powered. Capital of Science! Master of Maceball. Random fact, this is my absolute favorite theme in this entire game. You can't slide, by the way, when you have Power Mega Man. I'm holding down, and I'm hitting circle. I'm sure. See? Down. Circle. Just to prove a point, because somebody, like, a long time ago, years and years ago, was like, you can fucking slide with Power Mega Man, and I'm like, no, you can't. I'm like, you're a fucking idiot. What I love is that people that think they know so much about Mega Man, and I, being a walking Mega Man dictionary, think that they can outsmart me on the franchise. Now, if you are actually a Mega Man fan, you will know, good and well, that certain games didn't come out for certain consoles without being bootlegged. But yes. Anyway, back to my original point. I think the RoboEnzovirus was a prototype, and Zargon has mentioned this to me too, and he agrees, that the RoboEnzovirus that was used in Mega Man 10 is just a prelude to what became later on the Zero virus. I don't think Zero so much himself as a robot was meant to be this powerhouse, this badass, this monstrosity of just raw power, as he was a carrier for a virus that could eradicate the world, or at least the world of robotics. And I think that that's honestly what Wily was going for. I don't think he was trying to have Zero destroy the world. I think he was meant simply as a virus carrier. So, I believe that's my thought on it. And until Capcom makes a game that actually links Mega Man and X directly, we already know that light shows up in every damn X game because of the capsule system that they use in it. By the way, these things remind me of, like, oh my god, when you graduate from school, they have those, cap and gown, like the cap, graduation cap. That's what it reminds me it has on its head, and then when you shoot the cap off, it's like, fuck you, I can't graduate! I'm being serious, that's how I always thought it was. Then again, my mind goes in the wildest of imaginations, as I'm sure some of you people have, you know, some of you know, because, I mean, you subscribe to me, you should know that I'm a highly imaginative person, and I think that that's okay. I think a good act of imagination is healthy for a person. Oh god, what kills these things? Was it Yamato Spear? No. Plant Barrier. Plant Barrier doesn't even hit them! That is just funny. Blizzard Attack. Blizzard Attack works. Fire Blast. Flame Blast. No. And Silver Tomahawk. No. Now, once again, if you have Power Mega Man here, you can charge up, punch this block. That gate over there is a fake gate. Don't go to it if you want to get the beat parts. If you don't want to get beat parts, that's okay, too. Oh, and Power Mega Man, of course, destroys the things. He destroys everything in this game. If it's armored, you can just kiss it goodbye, because he can kill it. No, I need the Yamato Spear. But coming back to my point, I think that if they do somehow make a game that physically ties in the original series to the X series, then I think that will probably mark close to the end of the series. By the way, his shield, I'll go ahead and show this. If you're firing at him and he's got his shield up, you can't hurt him. See? But when he fires his night chain, you can just ignore it. Because, oh, he has to pull his shield aside. But if you have the Yamato Spear, you can just go right past his little shield. He's such an easy boss, it makes me cry. He's got such amazing music. He is such an awesome concept. By the way, Nightman and Windman were both robot masters that were winners of the Create a Robot Master contest that they apparently used to hold only in Japan. This was the first time that they held it in the US. You get the Night Chain to beat A parts for beating him, at least getting to this exit. They had a Create Your Own Robot Master thing, and I believe Windman was actually created by a Canadian guy, and Nightman was created by an American, and they both won. So we have not one, but two Robot Masters in this game. They were actually made by not Capcom. And there's usually one in every game that is not made by Capcom, because I think it was around the time Mega Man 2 got really popular, or maybe it was 3. They started holding this, by the way, he runs off a dry battery. Yet his water, or his level contains water. Tell me how that works. But he, Capcom started holding these Robot Master challenges, and I think that was a good thing for the Mega Man community. It showed that Capcom at one point cared about what their fans thought, about the input that their fans gave. And now it's like, this whole idea that Capcom doesn't care started with Mega Man Legends 3. And it kind of continued on into Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 in a way. I'll be honest, I'm a fan of the Ace Attorney games. Phoenix Wright should not have been in Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Oh, and those fish that like to jump out and kill you? Yeah, they make a comeback, and you actually see them in their natural environment here. There's 5. Damn short in the headset. Okay. I'm glad I actually am a fan of Captain Morgan's. It was either drink the Captain Morgan's or the Goldschlager that I have. Goldschlager's a bit rough. I haven't had that since I dated my ex-girlfriend, who is now my high priestess. Go figure. That tells you what kind of person I am. I hang on to friendships that I meet. All of them. I don't care. And speaking of, I had a friend of 10 plus years just toss me to the side today. And it kind of makes me laugh. I won't go into the details because they don't need to be gone into. But what I will say is that, you know, the circumstances, I forgot one little thing, and she blew up on me, and then blocked me. I was like, really? Apparently I was never your friend to begin with, so there was no point in this, and I don't feel bad for it at all. You know, she wants to throw me to the side like I'm nothing. By the way, congratulations, Mega Man 6, on having water that defies physics. Thank you. And that guy, I thought he was a cool-looking robot. Like, when I first saw him, I was like, he's neat. He's just a giant head with legs. But he's kind of coolly, like, neatly designed. I like his design. And, of course, you have to use the upside-down water to your advantage. And I will say that that is possibly the most unique mechanic anybody could have ever thought of. But I'm getting off track, as I usually do when I tend to drink alcohol, and I'm trying to make a point. I've not really used a lot of the Robot Master weapons so far. I need to start doing that. So we'll start going through this level with the Yamato Spear. I think the original series still has a bit of life to it, if Capcom will allow it to have some life. And I think that with the 25th anniversary right here, right now, upon us, tomorrow, you know, being Mega Man's birthday, how about I do this? Nope, can't reach him. If I had the Night Chain, I probably could. Wait, I do have the Night Chain. What am I talking about? Night Chain's like one of my favorite weapons in this game. It does circle back around, but it still uses the weapon energy. So, we'll just Yamato Spear this thing to death. That doesn't do anything extra. It just takes the same amount of shots. Skip that. We'll go to the real exit. By the way, if you go down that ladder, immediately to the right is the fake exit. And now we engage with Man-Horse-Man-Bot. Man-Horse-Man-Bot. The Robot Master version. I'm subtly British. Now, he's actually pretty cool. He's a... Oh, God, hang on. Just be on the safe side. He has a teleport with a time stop of sorts. Wait, I gotta let you hear this. Because I probably won't ever let you hear it in the LP, because I'll beat his ass so fast it's not even funny. Now listen. Okay, hang on. You can't tell me that gallop noise isn't cool. But if Capcom wants to save Mega Man and please its fans, they need to release Mega Man 11, I think this year needs to come out. Which, I'd love to see a Mega Man 11, don't get me wrong. But, you know, I mean, if they don't release a Mega Man 11, it's not a big deal. I mean, I'd like to see one, and it's been 2 years, and they released Mega Man 9 in 2008, they released Mega Man 10 in 2010, so we could potentially see Mega Man 11 this year. Just saying. It's 2012, right now. Next year's 2013. We have all of the Beat parts, so we have unlocked Beat. Our Battalion Battlebird, go! Of course, Windman is going to run off of wind energy. What else would you think? He's in the mechanical tower. They actually give you a battle location, too, which is kind of cool. Like, Nightman's in the impregnable fortress. My controller just died. That was weird. Okay, I'm using a PlayStation 3 controller. I've never had this happen before. So I unplugged the controller from the computer. That's what that bottle bong-om was. And okay, well, we're back to normal, so I actually had somebody ask why I prefer Nestopia to any other emulator. And I'll tell you why. This isn't an official Nestopia release. They've stopped work on Nestopia. The reason that I like this particular Nestopia first is the, oh my god, I can't remember what it's called, but the rate, the, response rate from when you press the button, and here's this stage's gimmick, gigantic fans, but the rate at which it responds to button presses is absolutely perfect. I've not seen another emulator that can handle fast button presses and have them respond at an absolute perfect timing. This was actually a private patch that somebody released to Nestopia, which is why it's not like 4.0, it's like 4.1 or 1.4.1 or something. Fuck me in the face! Or as they say in Panty and Stocking with Garter Belt, fuck me in the keyhole. Oh my god, I'm gonna run low on rum, apparently. And I realize I've been talking about the past of Mega Man and not the future, but I'm talking about the future at the same time. Because I think that the future of the future of Mega Man is key to its past. I think that with this, like I said, with this being the 25th anniversary, Capcom's got a lot to do to make up for all of the atrocities that the Mega Man fans have wanted, and that have raged over, and have cried over, and things that we should have. And I realize that, you know, we sound like a bunch of babies, Mega Man fans do, but we have really been screwed over by Capcom. I mean, now that I have more weapons, I want to see if Night Chain works. Nope. Does beat work on him? Nope. The only thing that kills these things is the Blizzard attack. Great. Actually, I think the Wind Tornado might do it, but I don't remember. Alright, so, let's try this again. That was interesting. That noise. But like I said, you know, I'm a firm believer that Capcom can fix their mistakes. They've put out several good games here lately. Whoa. I want to get up there. I want the health. I also want the energy tank. I mean, they've put out Super Street Fighter 4 Arcade Edition is an amazing fighting game. They didn't do so hot with Resident Evil 6, and Resident Evil 5 might as well be called Resident Evil Co-op, because if you're playing by yourself, you have a retarded AI that doesn't know what the fuck to do, and just wastes all your ammo and can't hit the broad side of a barn. Their new Devil May Cry game looks awful! Dante looks like a crybaby emo kid. Not to make fun of emo kids, but that's about the only thing I can compare him to. That's one way to kill those pandas. I like how they use pandas. So yeah, he has to be Chinese. I was thinking maybe Holland, because I know Holland is known for their wind energy, their windmills and such. Which, but then again, the Robot Master's design has a hint of Chinese to it, if you really look at it. You'll see in a moment, and I'll explain when I get there. But the future of Mega Man lies in its past. That's all I can really confirm. And this is almost reminiscent of Mega Man 5. We had the gravity hold, which hurt Gyro Man, which was a full-screen flash. We have the Centaur flash, which hurts Wind Man. Two wind-based bosses, and it's a full-screen flash that hurts him. This is the Centaur Flash, people. It's just a flash that's so bright that it actually causes physical harm to things. It also freezes time, apparently. Was it this game that... I know there's one NES Mega Man game in it. If you run out of ammo and you press the fire button, I think Mega Man still extends his arm. But I may be thinking of another one. Maybe in the X series, I don't remember, but we get the Windstorm. I thought it was Wind Tornado, I'm sorry. But I do believe, if they're going to make a Mega Man 11, they need to start wrapping up the original series, I believe. I mean, they can go on forever with it, and I'd be happy, I'd be content. I would be like, yo, this is freaking cool. I don't care to play classic Mega Man forever. It has a place in my childhood. It is one of those game series that... Is that a word? I mean, I said it thinking it's a word, but now I'm not sure if series is a word. I think it's just series, plural. I'll show you the Windstorm real quick with this guy. Kind of neat. It's just like bubble lead, but it does more. So I really like the idea that they took an old weapon, made it new again, but with a different idea behind it. That's one thing I love about the Mega Man series. They can take an old weapon and bring it back, change a couple of mechanics, and, you know, that's all she wrote. I mean, that's all you have to do to make Mega Man fresh, really. I don't care. I will play a Mega Man game if I think it is good. But it's one of those game series that, you know, I'd have a bad day in school. Oh, God. I'm going to try and show this off. Actually, no. I'm going to skip that path. I'm going to skip that path. I'll show it for the LP. That is an extremely hard path to take, and I think I may be too inebriated at this point to be able to show that off, so... But what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to stand on those ledges, somehow make just the tiniest jump that can make it. It's such a precise jump. And then have a charged Power Mega Man shot. I pressed jump! What the holy fucking balls! Great! Let's do that all over again, shall we? Actually, can Blizzard Attack reach him? I don't care to sacrifice some Blizzard Attack if I have to. No, it's not enough. I need something a bit more concrete. Oh, if you get hit while you're using Jet Mega Man, you will get knocked out of the jet. So. See, you can fire the Night Chain upwards. No! Oh god. Go to the left. come down, land on the guy. That's okay. At least I didn't land in spikes. Energy tank, go. God, this is not going good. This is not normally this hard, people. I'm sure when I get to the LP, you'll see me breeze through it like nothing, but I've had a couple of shots of Captain Morgan's private stock. By the way, I am a fan of rum, and a co-worker of mine mentioned Captain Morgan's, what was it, tattoo? And I was like, that sounds good. Actually, I've had it before, after I said something about it. It's pretty good. So if you are legal age to drink, I would like to suggest a couple alcoholic beverages. Oh my god, that is Power Mega Man! What the fuck am I doing? Lulls ensue. Ha! I got past you and didn't even have to kill you, you stupid hairdryer. Now, I haven't taken this path in... I want to say, let's see, I actually have a story about how I got this game. My aunt, her name's Karen, she used to be in the Navy. She spent 20 years in the armed services in the Navy. And she came in, she was stationed in, I think, Guam at the time. But she came in for she managed to get some leave time and she came in. And I'm going to go ahead and equip the jet just in case. I don't think I need to use it, but... No, I don't. Anyway, she came in from Guam. I think she was stationed there at the time. I might have been. There is actually video footage of me having beaten this game. And it was, I think, around Thanksgiving. I think my aunt found it. Because I came into the living room and... somebody filmed me and I said, I just beat Mega Man 6, and I was probably like 7, 8 maybe. I was an adorable kid apparently. I was very scrawny though. Like, it's kind of funny how that works. Come on, I'm just going to finish you off the Mega Buster. I'm not going to waste any more Fire Blast. Flame Blast, thank you. But I said something, I was like, I just beat Mega Man 6. And, God, I was such a gamer as a kid, too. If I ever find it, and I can figure out how to upload it to YouTube, I'll do it. I fucking swear I'll do it. But I need to get a hold of a DVD. I need to figure out how to convert VHS to DVD. That's going to be the tough part. And... Speaking of childhood memories, I was in a commercial as a kid. It's for something local, though, so don't get your hopes up it was anything major. It was for the local Wilma hospitals. They started an Ask a Nurse program. You could dial 1-800... What was it? I think it was like 1-800-ASK-NURSE or something. I don't remember the phone number now, but... The commercial, it was me, and it was a couple other kids, and we were like, we were standing around, we were at like camp or something, like, Boy Scouts camp. And, this is back when cell phones started getting popular, so I might have been, I was also doing theater at that time. Yes, I'm a person of multiple talents. I can do theater, I can do, a couple of voices. I apparently entertain you people with just being me, so... But we had, like, a camp counselor or something, like, or a Boy Scouts guy or whatever, and he was like... We were sitting around a campfire, and he was just like, okay, boys, what's the best treatment for poison ivy? And, so... The commercial, the funny thing about it is that we all had cell phones... that we borrowed from our parents before 12-year-olds started making cell phones mainstream, and every 12-year-old in existence started getting a cell phone, which I don't think 12-year-olds should have cell phones. But he was just, you know, he claps his hands. He's like, what's the best treatment for poison ivy? And we all dial the number, and we ask the nurse what the best treatment for poison ivy is. And if I ever can find that commercial, like, it's on VHS. It's another one of those things I'd love to upload, but it's got me in it. If I could figure out where that tape went to and how to get it onto a DVD to put it on the internet, it'll go up. But it wasn't anything... Was it Night Chain here? No, it was Silver Tomahawk. This is an interesting boss because if you notice, the Silver Tomahawk does have the most unique, like, curve of any Robot Master weapon. And one more. I want to try and Jet Mega Man this shit. Hold my beer, watch this. You know what? I got nothing to fear. Let's do it. I want to do this with the Jet Mega Man. Are you serious? I didn't even have to use the energy tank. That took two. I had three. That's just comical. The only place, I think, with the future of Mega Man that they can go is either a new spin-off, maybe a new concept, maybe reboot the series for the 25th anniversary. I think that would be an interesting concept. Start over from square one. I would love to play, you know, some new concept by Capcom. And I think that they could do really well if they... Of course, Capcom has long since stopped, you know, porting... You know, they've long since stopped publishing their own games. And I would absolutely love to just play something original that Capcom themselves could provide. You know? And it's... I don't know. I don't know what to think. I can't get up there. I need Jet Mega Man. See, they actually designed the levels around you to have to use the Jet or the Power Mega Man at least a little bit, and I do like that. Unlike Mega Man 1, where if you didn't pick up the Magnet Beam, you were screwed. Aww. Totally didn't think that was gonna hit. Let's see. Where else can my brain go? And the reason that that guy hit me just now is because I looked at the time. I am not kidding. It's 7:39 a.m. right now. So if you think about the length of this video and where it's currently at, you can find out exactly when I started to record. We'll shift that over. This area, I usually go through it with the Rush Jet, or not Rush Jet. Jet adapter, and I didn't, so I'm kind of impressed with myself, honestly. What's down there? Is there anything worth getting? I'll go this way, because I'll probably show the other path off during the LP just out of habit. But no. In all honesty, the future of Mega Man is from the past. I think they need to make a couple of sequels. Maybe Mega Man 11, maybe Mega Man X9, but I don't agree that X9 should exist. Because for those of you that know the history of the X series, you know damn well that X5 was supposed to have been the original ending to that series. And of course, Capcom went behind Keiji Inafune's back, and they said, no, fuck you, we're doing this our way. So, and of course, there's a lot of problems with the X game. I mean, X6 at least, so. Now, remember, this guy is weak to the blizzard attack. I think. Let me make sure. Was it Windstorm? No. I'm gonna make sure. I don't remember. He's one of those bosses I just don't remember the weakness to. I'm not gonna waste Plant Barrier, because that is so expensive. I think it really is. Yeah, it is. I guess it does the same amount of damage. We'll just finish him off with the Mega Buster. I think maybe another idea was if they made, like, a game that revolved around Bass. Besides Mega Man and Bass, obviously. I don't know how I got through that stage without dying. Considering the places I've died in this LP. And I know that went to the blizzard attack. I'll pause it and it'll be more charged. Boom! Called it! Then again, I did waste most of it on one boss, so... We'll snag that energy tank. Always can use another one of those. If they make a ZX, anything past the ZX Advent, I'm sure they'll be able to figure out something, because that's uncharted territory. So I think the ZX series would be a good place for them to go. I haven't, honest to God, played the Star Force games, so I can't really say if the Star Force games would be a good place to go with them as well. I don't know how those end. I own literally every Mega Man game, except the Battle Network and Star Force series. I don't own any Star Force games, and I only own the first Battle Network game. And the reason is because I never beat Battle Network 1. I got towards the end of the game and thought that the enemies were too hard, and I didn't feel like leveling, and I lost interest. Or didn't feel like grinding for Zenny to buy upgrades for Mega Man.exe. I'll go the normal path, because I know I'll probably go the other way during the LP. This path I find a lot harder. So you're in for a treat here. Whew, okay, I thought I was gonna fall into the pit there. Damn you with your revolver, your six-shooter. And see, that's where it ends. It falls down from here. This area is pretty tough, too. Anything with those stupid birds is actually fairly tough. I need... Nightchain? No! I kept walking. Fuck me. I thought Nightchain stopped my motion when I fired it. Oh well. Thank you. motherfucker, 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 motherfucker. I'm gonna need Pop-Tarts or something out past this. I'm about out of, rum, honestly. Ah! That one went down rough. I may switch to Jet Mega Man for that area. I think it would make my life a hell of a lot easier. I have a feeling if at this rate, I'm not going to be able to finish this game. How I finished Mega Man 5, I still have no idea. Yeah, I'm gonna have to go through here with Jet. There's no other option. I got through here, yay. I made it to the gate! Oh, fuck yeah! That's such a good feeling, I'd have made it to the gate. I don't know what I'd do if I didn't go. And I remember this one specifically being weak to the Flame Blast. It's such an easy fight. And that's it! We've got Mr. X right where we wanted! My scheme for world domination has failed, but I still have enough power to destroy you! What? You bastard! Let the final battle begin! It's the final battle because it's the last of the NES series, and I guess they didn't have Mega Man 7 planned out, and considering Mega Man 6 still did fairly well. I guess they were like, oh, well, we'll make a Mega Man 7. And it has an ingenious plot twist on what happens, so I won't spoil that. But we're now on Dr. Wily's laboratory, not Mr. X's. That whole time, you know, Mr. X, cheap disguise and all, was really, you know, it was really Dr. Wily to begin with. I can get through this area fairly quickly. I just have to know what I'm doing. Oh, God. Was it right here? Okay, in case I don't show you during the LP, I'm going to show you this spot. Because I can never friggin' catch it when I need to. Was it here? Okay, there's a couple of areas that have fake floors, and I'm going to fire Windstorm to make sure that I don't miss it. I think it's fake floors. See? I could have used that energy tank too, I'm sure. Okay, so it's all solid, so that's another thing the Windstorm is good for. We need some Flame Blast. As far as the X series goes, as far as the future of it, I think if they make an X9, like I said, Zero can't be in it, or he can only be in the intro stage. Or he has to be removed from the game pretty early because of story that happens between 8 and 9. I don't know, or between X8 and 01, rather. Let me rephrase that. This guy's kind of hard to hit because you've got to predict ahead of time what's going to happen with the Yamato Spear. Like, that shot went down. This shot will go up. That shot goes down. That shot goes up. It does make it a bit hard to hit him. But you want to hit him in the eyeballs. Let's drink something else besides rum here. Maybe this tea lemonade. Oh look, we start in an ice environment. Great. Here's where it gets kind of tricky. I'm glad I had the rush jet there. The jet adapter, anyway. I can't remember if there was more areas like that. Graduation cap, man! Go! Okay, there we go. At least they're giving me tons of weapon energy.
No, I'm right at the gate. Why didn't I just fall instead of jumping? Oh god.
I'm gonna use this opportunity to go run to the restroom. I'm gonna stop the video here and pick up right here. Okay, I'm terribly sorry about that. I needed to pee, and I'm sure that the rest of YouTube needed to know that too. Because, honestly, I have had a ton of liquid today. I have had, like, a quart of water because of last night. And, you know, I literally have not drank this much in my life in a single year. Not even when I turned 21 have I had this much booze. Whew. That's okay, this is the last game, and after this, it's all over. I won't have to have any more, oh, well, I'm playing an entire game and I'm taking a shot at every death. And I don't drink... See, I don't like beer, or I would do beer or something, you know, like drink X amount of beer per death. I don't like beer. I actually can't drink it. Guinness being about the only exception, and even then, it's still hard for me to stomach some Guinness. As much as Guinness is basically might as well be the best beer in the world. I feel like I've said... No, wait, I remember now. Okay. I was like, why does this feel like a different path? Oh, because of all the fucks that I give. Which is basically the situation I mentioned earlier about said friend and myself that I'm not giving details to. But she's not my friend anymore. If I'm that disposable to her, she's not worth my time. And I want you people to take a lesson from this. If a friend that you have known for 10 plus years is disposable, like if you are disposable to them, they were never your friend to begin with. It's basically just, this boss is he's a piece of shit. If you've got a full health bar, just fucking lay into him with the wind, what was it called? That tornado thing. Bubble Lead 2.0, we'll just call it that. Da-na-na-na-na. The windstorm is such a useful weapon that it doesn't like to be that used all the... Oh my god, that's fucking stupid. I need to stop singing. I'm just gonna stop. I don't even know where I was going with that song anyway. But it was in praise of the windstorm. I have one shot left in here. That's three alcohol bottles I finished off. Not entire bottles, mind you. I finished like half a bottle of Jack Daniels, half a bottle of Kentucky Gentleman, and most of this bottle of whiskey. Or not whiskey, but rum. That was a dick move. I forgot about this. I know that there's fans now, so I know how to predict it. Okay, well, that's not a good mechanic to be fighting against when you're intoxicated, let me tell you. I'm like seven shots in, and I thought that this game, considering I'd know it the least out of the original six, would be a good way to end a celebration. And I'm so glad for all my subscribers that have actually followed to this point. It does mean a lot. Because honestly, when I thought I started, you know, when I started doing this, I was like, I'll bet nobody more than like 50 people are gonna watch hour and a half, 2 hour long videos. But I think adding the timeline has really helped. The easy navigation timeline, which, of course, if you are new to watching these, you'll see it in the description. I have time links to every boss, every stage, so that you can watch the whole thing and still take a break. Especially with the last video, which was 2.5 fucking hours of recording straight. God, I regret that. Yamato Man is first. I want a fair, honorable battle, Yamato Man, and I'm going to do it. I'm not going to use his weakness. I'm going to give him one fair, honorable fight. You want to keep your distance from Yamato Man. It gives you reaction time. This is honorable. I am not using cheap special weapons. Why didn't I jump there? I fucking hit the jump button solidly. However, I'm not going to just sit here and not use an energy tank when I have 9 of them. Okay, so I'm done. I'm just gonna silver tomahawk him to death. But I could have beaten him, I think, maybe, without using Buster. Plant Man! The Voluptuous Vine, who is weak to the Blizzard attack, which has seen very little use. And it does shield from the Blizzard attack, so you have to make sure when you fire it, he has just thrown the shield off of him. But I guess since I'm getting close to the end of the game, I need to wrap up my thoughts about the future of Mega Man. As I've mentioned, I think that unless they make a new series that appeals to a broad audience, or appeals to the audience of all Mega Man fans, just all of us, or they make a sequel, or maybe even a special game that ties the entire Mega Man universe together, including the Battle Network series, and the Star Force series, and all of them. I think they could potentially do something awesome with the Mega Man series. Capcom doesn't make their own games anymore. I don't know if you people realize this or not. Ninja Theory did the new Devil May Cry game, and they fucked it up! Just from the pictures that I've seen, it's fucking terrible. Man Horse Man Bots! What's the line in that Dwayne and Brando song? Or not Dwayne and Brando, it's just Dwayne. He says, let's see. He says something about, your shot went over my head. Oh shit, they bounce back, yo. Ah! Something like that. Oh shit, they bounce back. But, you know. The Centaur Flash's only fucking use in this game that I can think of, because I picked it up too late in the game to really try and capitalize on anything cool with it. I may use it in the LP and just goof off to show it off. But, oh, and I never did explain. If you notice, if I don't hit my headset, when he's spinning his head, his hair, if you think about, like, Chinese kung fu martial artists, sometimes they'll have that one strand in their hair that's braided, and it just kind of, like, they'll be bald everywhere else, but that spot in the middle of their head is braided. Think about it. That's what he's spinning around when he does his attack thing. It's fucking Chinese, people. Has to be. I was thinking it was Holland, because I know Holland, once again, is famous for their use of wind energy. But, nope. Wind Man is Chinese. I wish I could remember where Plant Man was from, though. Now, we didn't see this weakness earlier. The Windstorm goes right through his shielding type fire waves. Something else to think about. The reason that this game was rushed, if you notice, every weakness is 4 points of damage, except for one. Except for one. They didn't have time to come up with proper damage adjustments. They only had the main weaknesses, which all did 4 points of damage. They didn't have the music completely fine-tuned. Some of the stages seem like they're lacking in areas. They seem too... The bosses are too simplistic in this game. They could have done so much more with this game. And this is why I continually insist that this could have been one of the best Mega Man titles ever made. But it won't happen. I would love to see it's completed. I mean, you can play through it, you beat it, there's no problems with that. But we'll take out the Canadian Blizzard Man next. By the way, all my friends in Canada that I've known for years, hello! I wave at you. And this is how our weapons are holding up at this point. I wonder if Beat works here. Oh, right. I should show off Beat, at least, in this game. Honestly, Beat's kind of useless in this game. He doesn't really have a benefit of anything. And I think he costs 2 points of... 2 points per hit. Although I can't honestly... What the fuck? Oh, God. We're gonna switch over to Beat. Nope, he still takes one. He still does the same thing. I love you, Beat. You're so great. And if you change screens, Beat disappears, so you have to resummon him. Fuck, why didn't I... Thanks, Beat. I could have gone to one random weapon. Nope, he doesn't do anything. Now, I know the Silver Tomahawk is very effective against this boss form. And I love this boss theme, so I'm actually going to be quiet for some of this. It is my favorite, absolute favorite Wily boss theme. So all you get to hear is my button presses. This is also one of the few times where we actually see a third health bar out of Dr. Wily. It is one of the only times that you will see it. And Beat does not work here. And it's also a much larger capsule. And I don't remember what to use here. Let's test. One. With the limited weapons that we have, this may take a bit. One. One. Okay, Blizzard Attack is not even worth it. I don't remember. Did that see two? Nope, that was one. And he's gonna kill me if I don't use it because he's mid-attack. That's two! Nightchain! Holy shit, Silver Tomahawk! I want to do this. I want to do this with the Nightchain. Because it's my favorite weapon in the game. He's also my favorite boss in the game. I'm going to finish him off with the Mega Buster. I don't want to use anything else. I think it'll be a perfect way to end the celebration. Mega Man has at last captured Dr. Wily. Triumphant at last, Mega Man arrested the notorious Dr. Wily and brought him to justice. Sentenced to prison for his crimes, Dr. Wily now rules over a prison cell. At long last, the world is at peace. We get a staff roll. With a cool, unique to this game, like remix of all the boss themes in an ending theme. It's really nice. Blizzard Man's so cool, he likes to use some skis to get around. But the bosses in this game, they really fit with the idea and the theme that they were going for. I mean, you have robot masters that literally represent the world over. And the reason that I think Centaur Man is Greek is because of their mythological background with Zeus and such. With Flame Man, of course, you know, a lot of oil is over in, like, the Middle East. And you get, you know, the stereotypical, you get the old... By the way, he has a goatee! He has a goatee. I wanted to point this out. He has fucking facial hair. But yeah, you know, all the oil is in the Middle East, so obviously it's going to be kind of hilariously stereotypical. But I'm a huge fan of stereotypes, because there is some truth to them. despite how funny they may be. Like, black people like chicken. I've never known a black person that doesn't like chicken. There it is, Daniel Valley. See? He was made by an American. Bum-ba-da. Plant Man is so fabulous, he throws his plant barrier all over the room. He jumps around and then he's all immune to your attacks, and then he likes to jump all up on top your face. He's just a punk-ass bitch. That literally sums him up, in my opinion. He's so easy, but he's kind of unique in a way. I like him. I like Plant Man. Tomahawk Man, I thought, was an amazing representation of North America, because we have a history with the Native Americans, which, you know, are commonly called Indians, but they're not from India, so they're not Indians. But we have a rich history with the Natives, and it's not good. I mean, it's rich in that there's so much that happened, but it's not good. We had the Trail of Tears, for fuck's sake. That wasn't a good thing in our history. I thought Wind Man was clever. See, Michael Leader, another American, or another English-speaking person. If I remember right, Michael Leader was Canadian when he came up with the robot design. And I may not cover these things in the LP, so I'm going to go ahead and cover them now. With Yamato Man, I really thought it had brought out the spirit of the Japanese people with the whole Bushido, samurai, and I really felt that this was an extremely strong entry in the series, or it could have been if it wasn't rushed. The reason that this game was rushed is because that it falls right there at the end of the NES life cycle. I mean, this game came out for the NES when shit was coming out for the Super Nintendo. Turkey 613, people! Ba-ba! But yes, this was around the time Street Fighter 2 got big, and they started using that more modern Capcom logo, and all Capcom staff. So I want to say special thanks to Hyper Benji, just because you have a cool name, and Duke. How do they end this game? Presented by Capcom, very plain. To be continued. So I guess maybe I forgot that it says to be continued at the end of the game. So I'll finish up my thoughts. You all got a couple minutes, I'm sure you can listen to me and listen to my points of view here. To summarize, Mega Man's future lies in their past. Everything that they've done for the last 25 years needs to come to a culmination in either one massively awesome game that conglomerates every franchise that they've ever had. Classic Mega Man, Mega Man X, Mega Man Zero, Mega Man ZX, Mega Man Battle Network, Mega Man Star Force. All of it. They need to conglomerate this into either one gigantic game for their 25th anniversary, or they need to make a sequel to a game that doesn't have a definitive end. The Classic series. The X series. Despite how I mentioned earlier, there's some rules that they need to follow storyline-wise with Mega Man X9. And Mega Man Legends 3. As well as a potential... Now, I don't know much about the Battle Network series. I've not played all of it. I do plan on playing it. Battle Network 7, if it's possible. Or a Star Force 4. I don't know how Star Force 3 ends. Or they could possibly do a ZX3. They need to do this. This is what I see in the future of Mega Man. What I see in the future of Capcom. And if they don't do this, I'm going to go ahead and flat out say it. I've been hinting at it the entire video. If Capcom does not put out Legends 3 in this year, in the year of 2013, they're going to have problems saving the series. Legends 3 is the game that everyone wants. And I know that one of my good friends, Doug Herbert, he runs the Sorry Gaming Network. You should check him out. They're on Facebook. He's a huge Legends fan, and I know he has made mention of his disappointment over Legends 3 and his support behind it. So, and I have a lot of support for any Mega Man game because it's one of those series is that when it comes out, you know, when it's released, a lot of people are like, oh, it's just the same game. Sure, it has very similar gameplay mechanics to the previous installments. But I think I said it in my previous video, if it's not broke, don't fix it. If people like a game, they're going to flock to it. Make it how you think it should be made. But I want to wrap up here. Okay, that was a weird bit of lag. But I want to wrap up here and say I want to thank you all for watching the last week. And the final thing I want to say, no matter what happens with this next year, I will always, always play the classics. Because between Mega Man and Doom, I survived high school. Let's just put it that way. And I probably wouldn't be the person that I am today without, you know, having some sort of influence with the classical Mega Man series. So, I mean about my microphone there. I can't believe I got through all the Dr. Wily stages without drinking so much. But yeah, I think I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up. I like this theme, but I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up so you don't have to listen to me ramble anymore. I'm Ultima Mantoid, and this is Let's Celebrate Mega Man's 25th Anniversary. Until next time, take care and have fun. Because games are meant to be fun.